Okay, going back. Well, I'll turn the compressor off in a minute. I want to get some air built up. I'm not going to spray it, but I use it to clean everything as it goes. But I got my stuff out. This is my favorite finish. Flectovera. It used to be called Flectovera thing. It's called Spar Varnish. And UV protection formula out for outdoors. And I use it for, you know, the chemists in the bathroom. They last longer than regular finish. And, I forgot I had the air compressor going. Anyway. Yeah, my air compressor don't have automatic shutoff. It wears me out running around. So this is a Flectovera thing. I was just guessing at what I was showing. This is the new kind. It used to be called a Flectovera thing. Now it's owned by Rust-Oleum. And this is the has UV protection from the sun, you know. And it's oil-based, and it's for outdoor use, but it works really good on cabinets, like bathroom cabinets, because, you know, they get a lot of humidity and water. So, I gotta get my brushes ready. Got some old ones that I'm going to try to soften up. If they don't soften up, I'll use a brand new one. I used to use lacquer thinner, but I like mineral spirits nowadays. Well, I have for about 15 or 20 years now. Nowadays, anyway, I did a lot more work when I was young, so it seems like all my memories are from when I was young. Maybe dried up. This, I know it had a skim on it. Let's see if I can break it and get enough out to do this with. I was actually trying not to get it on this end of the table where I'm going to be sanding. No good. Gonna have to throw that one away. There's not much left in there anyway. I got another one that's brand new, I think. This is not the one I'm going to use, but I thought I'd show it. This one's pretty good too, I think. This is a water-based polyurethane. Yeah, soap and water cleanup, but that's not what I want for outdoors. smoothing it up. It didn't need it to be a mailbox bottom, but now this, there won't be no dirt on it, and the finish will stick to it good. I used to be a cabinet maker back in the 70s and 80s, so everything has to be smooth. So anyway, now I gotta clean it with the air blower. Felt like something landed on my leg and neck, and there's been some. Actually, I haven't seen one in the last week, this week, but a couple months or two ago, I was out here and a whole swarm of bees was attacking me the whole time I was out here. So I saw the little black. It wasn't a bee. It was some little dirt dauber or something earlier. It kept getting in my face. So I think that's what it was. Thing all over. checking the video. Yeah, I'm going to just use that paper. I was going to break up that box, and then it was full of paper, so that'll work. My other brushes are still hard to rock. They're just about ruined. That's brand new. I hate to use it at all just for something like that, but I forgot. this Vectivera thing that I was talking about is pretty good looking. So it kind of makes it kind of golden, so if you don't like the golden view, I did some white oak cabinets for the bathroom, and I did them with this, and I didn't put any stain or anything on it. I like it on pine too. I don't know if I ever put it on pine before, but I'll let that sit there for just a little bit. It's just, you know, it's not a piece of cabinet work or anything, so it's just gonna be flipped here in a second. Now maybe I'll try to figure out how to lean it against that cardboard triangle so that it doesn't touch the whole side, you know, just the corners or something. Let's see. If I had a better place to put this, I don't think I do. In the painting of anything. Let's see if it'll sit on this box. I don't think it will. Maybe. Yeah, we'll try that. I mean, if I don't bump into it, it'll probably be alright. It's just kind of barely hanging on there. Yeah, I guess that's the best way to have that box. There you go. I was trying to see if there was a way I could do it so it wouldn't be touching. Yeah, here we go. Do it like this. I hated to use this stuff, but it's the best protector I got, and everything. There's some other stuff in the garage that would be 30-45 minutes to get out, and another 30 minutes to put everything back. So I got too much junk. Nice breeze today, at least. It actually seems a little cooler now than it was this like noon and one. I don't think there was much of a breeze then. It was 88 when I looked around that. It's a little, usually a little drear, too cooler out here in 8 where I live. It was up in Fort Worth. Didn't have time to go. I didn't want to take time to have on my desktop, on my Fedora 23. You can set the temperature, you know, just a little up on the top where you can see it. But it doesn't do. This is the side that's going to show here. It doesn't do Hazel, Texas, will be the town, or just those bigger towns. Paper's going to want to stick to it. It doesn't want to lay flat. That's one reason why I thought I should use. I should have used. Should have used a cardboard box like I had originally started to do, a piece of it. I've got some that's really, really big, like, and I didn't want to, it wasn't going to fit here, so I thought, well, I'd cut that other one up. Then when I saw it was full of that paper, I thought, well, that's the perfect thing, except for the breeze. If it was any windier, I couldn't use the paper. Look at all this stuff off the lid and get it back in there. I got it on sale for $25 a can, but it's still not cheap to me. Pretty expensive for a quart of anything, I think. Yeah, that wind is making the phone rock. It's going to fall off there if I don't watch it. Now my hands are too greasy to touch the tripod. Let me get all the lids in there. Shoot. Okay, so take these off. If I take them off, then I can't. There's no way to pick that up without getting this junk all over it. Just take them off of this. I hate these things. They make you hands sweat like crazy, even in the winter. But I think even at that, I prefer wearing them to getting that jump all over my hands and having to try to get it off. That is, if you can ever get it all worked out. If you don't forget where you put things, do what I just did. You go get a. Here we go. I knew those were coming handy. Been in there forever. They're covered in dust. I'll lay them on top of the lid while I'm banging on it, and then it won't go all over the world. Shake everything off of it. And I can show you one in a minute. Okay. Now, I guess I'm going to have to let that dry a little while. I can do, there's other things I've been needing. Okay. We're gonna let it dry a while. Sure, I think. Well, I didn't want to let it, you know, set overnight. Okay, this is what I was gonna show you. See these? These are those plastic sawhorses. They were on sale for like $12 each at Sears, at the local Home Sears store. And I know why. Because they collapsed at the drop of a hat, and one of those little bars is already broke on one of them. It goes backwards. Well, it came off. They come off it too, real easy. If you bump into them. But I had something. They're rated, you know, at like 200 pounds each or something. I don't remember. Anyway, I had something about a half of that on there, and I kind of knew to watch them. You know, just like common sense. But I tried to move it off of. I had it on like two or three of them. It was a copier, Xerox copier, old heavy one, and I can't lift it by myself anymore. I used to could, and it it collapsed. All of them just collapsed at once on me. I was trying to get it into that van door there. I had it out here in the driveway, trying to get into that side door of that van. It hurt my arm and all kinds of crap, and so they're very unsteady, very weak, weaker than. Than you would even expect. I mean, they collapse even easier than I expected. So I gotta take a little break. Oh yeah, here's one side of the garage. Can't get into that side. And then the other side is where my tools and stuff are, and you can barely get around. And the only way you can work really is to come out here and bring stuff out here. But here's my chair. I gotta sit down and have a drink, get cooled off. But I guess that's all I got to say right now. I got some stuff I need to move around anyway, some wood and stuff. So I'll let that kind of dry for a while, and then maybe it'll get dry enough I can stick it back in that mailbox without completely ruining my brand new finish. I could let it dry till tomorrow, but then I can't really because the mail will come before I get it out there on the way. I'm not going to be coming out here at 6 in the morning and getting it ready about, 9 or 10. I got up at about 8:15 today, which wasn't bad, pretty good for lately. But it took me till 11:30 to get outside. Then I ate and got dressed and got myself together. Okay. Of course, I've all got all those tools to put up, too. I kind of hate to put them up till I'm sure I'm done working them. Okay. Well, this is done. I'll probably come back when I put the mailbox back, put it together.